Hello friends, welcome to my channel Real Life Experience. I have this laptop. This is Dell Latitude E7440, and unfortunately this screen is broken. As you can see, I cannot see anything, no pictures, nothing is coming. So I have ordered this screen from Amazon.com. I checked with the model number, the serial number, series number, and accordingly I have ordered this screen. So I'm trying to replace this screen myself. I hope that I'll be successful. If not, then I will give it to some mechanic.
This is the screen which I LCD which I have ordered, and hopefully it should work. Yes, everything looks as per the specifications. Here is the plug wherein all the connector cables would be joined from the system, and these are the screw holes wherein which will be fixed on this monitor screen. So let me see. Okay, now for opening this, you need to actually get it snapped here. Like say, you can take any sharp object, maybe you can take a dime or a penny will also do. So you have to actually just pop it up, see if you see. Yeah, it should easily come out. This is nothing but a plastic sheet, plastic cover, which protects the screen. You will need one Phillips screwdriver. There are four screws. One is here, one is here, one is here, and one is here. So, which you need to... Okay, well, my daughter was suggesting me to just remove the battery before I do anything. So I'm just going to snap away the battery. So battery is removed now. This is the battery pack which can just get snapped away. So here again, coming back to our screen. So I'm going to just open this, the four screws. This is the star screw. The screen should easily come out. Okay, but you have to be very careful. You should not pull it that much so that the wires or any connectors will get damaged. Here, this is the plug which I was showing you, where the connector which connects all the, you know, cables coming from the system. So we have to be very, very careful with this. There is a blue, this is the sellotape which we have to pop it up. And then this is the sealing for the sealing for the connector, which we have to keep it separately. And actually, for removing this, you have to very carefully pop up. If you can just show, is it visible? There's a small pop-up, you know, lock. As soon as we remove, this is the lock. So as soon as you remove this lock, this cable should come out easily. So, yes. So this is the old screen, the damaged one. And now I'm going to replace this with the new screen. So again, I need to connect this. I have to keep this in the same position wherein originally the other one. And I have to just make sure that the connection should be proper, because that is the most crucial thing. Once you get connected properly, then everything would be, you know, easy. the lock should go back. Now, I'll just put this the blue sticker to just to protect the connections, and I'm going to use only one or two screws just to check whether it works, because if it doesn't work, then you know we have to redo the things again. So I'm going to make sure that it has been, the screen is working. I'm going to attach the battery to it and make sure this should work. So I have put on the power switch. Yes, it's good. So the major challenge is when you're ordering the screen, it should match with the model, because if it doesn't, then your all the labors and hard work will be of no use. So if it works, that means it should match, the hardware should match hardware with this new screen. So yeah, I think now I'm going to put these two extra screws, and then we are good to go.
We have to put this cover once again. So we are all good. Let me just once again start this, and yes, we are good to go. The basic idea for this whole video and exercise was, when the screen got broken, I was very concerned and I was really scared, like, was I go to some mechanic to get it repaired? They may charge me 200, 300, I don't know. So I asked few people. Somebody says $250, someone says $175, somebody says $225. And so that was my concern, because now this laptop is almost 3 year old. So I didn't want to spend that much money. So I thought, if I can manage it within say $100, that is fine. I don't want to spend more than $100 on this. I checked the rates online on Amazon, eBay, those sites, with the serial number and model number. And fortunately, I got this for $79 plus with taxes. It cost me $81. So $81, and my half an hour time investment, that's all, and we are good and up and running. So my suggestion to my viewers would be, you can also try out doing the things yourself, because sometimes the things looks very complicated, but actually they are not. You have to use your resources. We have the YouTube, we have Google, so you can keep looking for different resources. Because any problem you are facing, that's not the first time you are not facing. Somebody might have faced in the world, and if we can use their experiences and we can get the things done, that would be good for us. And that's why the channel is real life experiences. So you learn from the other people's experiences and you use in your own life. Thank you. If you like the video, please hit like and share button, and keep watching. Thank you. So friends, I hope you like this video, real life experience. So somebody's experience, which I have also used. I saw this video, couple of videos on YouTube, and I thought to try to fix it. In worst case, what will happen? Worst case, I may not be able to fix it and I have to give it to somebody to repair. But before giving to somebody, I wanted to try myself, and you know, this is working. So this is what the real life experience is. As my channel says, you have to learn from other people's experience. So I have learned from other people's experience. Are you trying to learn from other people's experience or my experience? If you like it, please like and share, and propagate this video to as many as people you can. Thank you.